Hey everyone, welcome back again to Vanilla Minecraft Skyblock. I said three names in different orders, and I always say them in different orders, so get used to it. You may notice up here in the sky a random person floating. That is another account that I hold. I've got him, or her, I guess, because it's the wife's account, actually, who's used it twice 3 years ago. But they're just going to serve as a camera of sorts to, I guess, time-lapse stuff. And you can hear zombies and skeletons under here. There is a small platform where the sandstone used to be, or the sand island that I've cleared out. But as you can see, the island is finished. I've got some trees going here. I have a little tiny hut, which is not anything special. It's just my cobblestone generator hidden away where I can kind of AFK. What I've been doing is I've been putting stuff on top of my mouse to hold down the mouse button, and I could just walk away for 5 minutes, come back, change out the pickaxe, and come back, rinse and repeat, and give myself large amounts of cobblestone. So we have this at the moment. We'll see how far that gets me. I have a feeling it won't as far as I want it to, and not a whole lot of wood either. We have some watermelon and some pumpkins around here in various places, and also someone has gone to the nether and got us some mushrooms. And sugarcane and birch trees are coming eventually too, because they were in the nether, but there was only one of each. Because I made it that way. So other people are working on that. But as you can see, some of which are getting quite a bit ahead of us. I have the largest surface area, though, I will say. But I don't have the height. I don't have castle walls going up. I don't have a mob spawner yet. And I don't have any other fancy things. That must be P51 over there. Chillin, got rid of some of his cobblestone pillars. I don't know if I showed you guys those before, but they dumped lava over the side and water on top of that, and it was a whole mess, but he has finally cleaned that up. I guess that's their alternative cobblestone generator, but I suppose we will get going on this whatchamadoozits mob spawner today, and we'll see exactly what happens. I'm probably not going to have enough wood. I'll grab myself a pickaxe and an axe, just so that I can fix my mistakes that I made. I'll grab a little bit of cobblestone to start out with, and maybe a little bit more than a little bit of wood. I guess I can turn this all into planks right now. And what I can do too, how do you make slabs? That's a pressure plate. It's a 3 wide. I need a crafting bench. What I can do is get myself a bunch of slabs right now too, and I'm gonna cheat a little bit and use slabs instead of full blocks to save myself some resources in some places, because I can. I could go more extreme to this if I wanted to, but I'm choosing not to. So the next thing that I'm thinking right now is I'm going to have the mob spawner over there. I'm missing a torch here. My perfect pattern. That's very tragic. Maybe I should take some of those with me too. Oh, this guy's here. Yeah, you better run. Oh, bye. He died. I guess grab some torches. That's what I was doing before I got distracted by him. And then after that, we can get ourselves some goodies. So planning out how the spawner, the mob system, whatever you want to call it. It's not really a spawner because they're just natural spawns, but call it whatever you want. Where am I going to put this exactly? I've decided at the back. It's just the question of how far to the back. I was thinking earlier about expanding it farther back and putting the platform farther back and putting the spawner farther back, because I want to have room for the home, which is semi-large that I have planned out. It's probably going to come back to at least where these trees are. But I suppose if I really need to, I can build farther that way. I can cover up some of the pathway that leads there and do whatever I need, so that's not a big issue. My hut will be gone eventually. I'll have a better looking thing there and more organized storage system and various things like that. And yeah, so I guess we'll just get started. I can't sprint now. I don't really have food except for that watermelon, but I don't really want to eat it. Usually I just jump off the edge. I don't really need to run right now anyway. So where is the exact middle of this thing? I believe it is the... Oh, hi tree. Welcome to the world. I believe it is this. It looks like it is. I think it is. We're going to go with that. The little piece of the plank in the bottom there. So, let's build it right around here. I don't really have a distance planned. be nice if it was mostly over top of this platform, so that if I fall off and kill myself, that I don't lose everything. And I want to make this 23 blocks tall. 23 is the number of blocks you have to drop a mob in order to kill it, at least for zombies and skeletons. It has to be a little bit farther for witches, because witches have more health. The design I have here isn't going to work for spiders, which is something I kind of thought about a little bit, and I decided, heck with it. I don't think I'm going to need that much string. I can make wool from string, bow from strings, a bed from wool, and stuff like that, but I don't really plan on using wool as a building block at any point, so I'm not too worried about that. If I need something white and light-colored as a block, I can get snow. I have a few, I think a stack and a half of snow blocks already. But let's build this up 23 blocks, and even with 23 blocks, sometimes a mob will survive. I think it grabs the water, and you'll see how this works at the top later on. But I think it grabs the water sometimes and just kind of clings to life and shortens its fall by one block. But that's okay, because we have to swing our own weapon to kill them if we want to get certain drops or if we wanted to get experience. But I don't think we can even... Can we even get... I guess we could enchant things, right? We can't get a diamond. We can't... Okay, so whatever we get would be just from mob drops. So maybe they would drop a unbreaking shovel or something like that, but I don't think we're going to get too many fancy things, and worst case, we can use an anvil for that. That's what we'd use that for anyway. So anyway, enough rambling. Let's build up. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Isn't counting fun? Go on, count with me, kids. No. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. All right, so yay counting. I'm going to go ahead and build up one more block, and then we'll build out from this a little bit. And I'll leave that hole right there, and that'll be where the mobs are going to fall down. So, simple enough, right? All right, I looked back over my shoulder at my other computer that's going to record from that perspective, and I see my camera's not high enough up. I'm going to give you guys a time lapse. Hopefully that works out quite well. I do have time limited a little bit. I am limited in time a little bit today, but I think that I'm going to cram it all into one video anyway, even if I do run out of time. I'm not sure I'll have enough resources either. I'll probably jump down there and grab some trees at some point too. But I'll probably make this two layers tall, as you'll see here in the next couple minutes. And we will get back with you at that point. right, we are pretty much done this thing now. It's all built. There's two layers to it, just like I wanted. I still need to add water on the inside, and I have some torches in there I need to knock out too. And I will bring you along for that. Hopefully nothing has spawned. I did, like I said, I left some torches in there. And I left some torches on the outside too, so I haven't actually even using the camera, which you can barely see through the snow there now. I haven't looked around at this, because I don't want to be cheap a little bit to see what was around. But as you can see, this is what I have left for supplies. This is all the cobblestone I had. Remember how much I had at the beginning? This is how much wood. So the wood held out better. You could see my design, which I'll talk about when we get in there more, but there was slabs on the bottom and full planks on the top. I did that to be a little bit cheap in resources. That saved me quite a bit. And I didn't cover up the entirety of the sides. Don't worry, light cannot shine through the slabs like that. I checked that, so that won't affect the spawning. But now I have two options for getting down from here. One of them will be to climb through here and take the ladder. Or I can jump. I guess I should be sensible and use the ladder, right? No. Not at all. Whee! And then we spawn on top of the roof, because in Villa Minecraft, where you spawn is sort of random. If this is set as the main spawn point of the world, you could spawn within like a 12 block radius or something like that. Oh, look at that from a distance. That looks kind of neat. That almost in a way looks like a face, or faces, doesn't it? That's weird. Alright, oh, now it's a nice sunny day all of a sudden. Sun's rising. Oh, it's bright. Oh, I'm used to looking at darkness on my screen when it was snowing there the whole time, and now it's like, that actually hurts. Actually hurts the eyes. Alright, after this I can get a real farm going and start planning and saving for a house and stuff like that. So there's still a few details to work out. Let's get my stuff here before I forget about it. For example, there isn't an actual chute ready yet. Like I said, water inside needs to be done. And, you know, tiny details like that. But as far as I can tell, I think I don't think I missed any holes. I'll have to go up there and take a closer look at some point, but we'll be able to see once we're in there too. It's kind of neat. I'm afraid of going up there to get this thing ready with the water, because if there's a creeper that spawns in there and he blows up on me as I'm taking the torches out, which he shouldn't spawn that close to me, but still, it's nerve-wracking, then I am in some trouble. I put torches on the outside so they shouldn't spawn on the outside edges. I think I got all the torches covered everywhere, the torches on the roof, of course. But yeah, I just need to design some sort of chute and a few details like that, as I've said 8 times by now. And then we are good to go. I'm just going to dump most of my stuff. I'll take the ladders just in case. In here, what should I take? Take some cobble in case I need blocks to keep the table just in case. I need the water. I have a single bucket around here. And I, of course, have no way of getting more iron. Where's that bucket? There's the water bucket. So, I think the first thing I need to do here is, let's do this over here a little bit closer, since apparently I'm going to have to climb a ladder a bunch of times. Hey, there's the cobblestone. It must have fell all the way from that top hole. Let's do this. And on the side of efficiency, what am I doing? This is not right at all. I can make basic shapes. My torch! That I'm so worried about. Oh my god, I did it again! Alright, torch, you're messing me up. I'm blaming the torch for all of my downfalls in life. There's a water. Run on over here. Yes, grr, zombies, grr. I'm gonna grab this water, excuse me, which I've punched through into the void now. And I can't run anymore. Dang it. Go! 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 I ended up eating the apples I picked up earlier. At some point, when I cut down some of these trees, I think I did that during the whole thing. Take this bucket. I chopped down some trees to get more wood, thinking I would need it, and collect a few apples. I ended up eating them up on top, because as I was finishing that, I started starving to death. All of a sudden, I'm like, well, why am I taking damage? Starving to death, you dummy. So now this is the boring process of placing all this water. We're gonna be lots of ups and downs on this ladder, so I'll save you the trouble or the pain of watching most of it because that'll be boring. But I'll give you the gist of what's going on. 5 cobblestone. Yeah, I should only need 1. Actually, good thing I brought these ladders because I do need to get up there. 2, 3, 4. I think I'll just cheat and do something like this. I can use these 3 ladders. Break that one out for now. To get up here. And the water. If I place a ladder here, I don't think it'll flow. I think that'll stop it properly. Yes, perfect. The ladder counts as a full block. Alright, so I'll patch up the ceiling here. Then I'll have to get rid of these torches, and something I should be doing, because recording. Turn up the brightness. Should have done that a long time ago. Yeah, get rid of these torches, get the water. These to go there, in each of these corners like that, and then one in each of these corners here too, under the gaps that I have. And then the water will flow, it'll end right before it gets to the hole there, so it'll just kind of push mobs off into and down the hole below. And of course this whole thing won't be here. Did I hear a spider? Oh, that reminds me, did I up here before I completely forget about it? Oh yes, I did. I was worried I didn't put the slabs on top of these. The slabs are to prevent spiders from spawning. Since they won't fit down the hole, it'll just clog it all up. But yeah, I think that's that. I'll get back to you when I'm actually ready to get the entirety of this thing. When I'm ready to turn the on, to flip the switch. When I'm ready to flip the switch. Yes, words. Alrighty, looks like this is going to be the last water bucket. I'm just going to double check here. This is the bottom floor that I'm on. To make sure that I didn't miss anything. Because I don't want to have to come back up here again. Let's place that water there. Let's go ahead and break this cobblestone out. By the way, I thought I was out of cobblestone, but I have like, I don't know, 18 more stacks, 17 more stacks in the chest down there that I might have shown you, but anywho, we had lots to spare, which is good. So I just need to go up to the other floor, get rid of these torches up there, do the same for here, which I might as well do while I'm here. I don't care about actually recollecting them. Can't quite reach that one. That's okay. Just gonna place these. Dang it. These ladders. Oh, don't fall. Okay, not that you're really gonna fall because there's ladders there. Ah, mess. What a mess. Alright, going down. There we go. Alright, now it's dark enough for mobs to spawn. Make sure I take that stone out of here too. The water can properly flow. When I built this back in my single player world years ago, jeez, it's a long time ago. Okay, I plugged a hole in the ceiling. I left one of these blocks in the mob spawner and I was wondering, why isn't it working so well? Well, turns out there was a dozen mobs stuck behind this thing on one side. So it looks like now, I know it's dark, bear with me. The light you can see is through those slabs, which if we were to go into F3, we would see that it doesn't actually shine through the light. So don't worry about that. But it looks like everything is working as intended. So now we can go ahead and get rid of the ladder we put in here. And it looks like, let's see if I can get up a little bit. There we go. Looks like everything is good to go on this floor too. No light coming from above. No real holes. Just the gaps between the slabs, which will make no difference. And alright. I just have to put the pillars here, some kind of chute to have fall eventually, but I won't worry about that quite yet because it doesn't really matter too much. And at any moment we should have mobs starting to come out of it. They won't spawn when they're super close to you, so it'll take a moment for them to spawn and follow those platforms into the water and get pushed down here. But soon enough it will happen. Might as well fill this bucket while we're here. There's a zombie flesh in the ground. There was a zombie that fell. We missed him. But he was there. And you know what? Doesn't help. Let me... that player is floating up in the sky beside the spawner. That's going to affect things. There we go. I have to be careful. Some of these guys might survive the fall, which is why I need to shoot. If they catch the water just right, they might be able to survive it. But there we go. They're falling. They're going to drop things like bones from skeletons, random torch that got pushed out, zombie flesh, gunpowder. We can't make TNT because we're pretty limited on sand. We can make like two pieces or something. I don't know. And here they come. Ow, that guy sniped me on the way down. What a jerk. But yeah, it's working out pretty good. Yeah, and we'll work on making this thing better in the future. Maybe what I'll do temporarily here. I just kind of put a bit of a thing around here. Just so that anything that falls out, if it happens to survive, it looks like it might not. Maybe I was one block shorter when I tested this in creative. But just in case anything does survive, it can't get out. A creeper can't come surprise me when I'm working over there or something, you know. Get blown off the edge with all my stuff on me. And I'll grab a door for here too. I can't run, but I can just make a door. I'll make a door. Where was that? Why did I hear a creeper explode? Please don't tell me there's a mess up there. Okay, the door can wait. I wish I could sprint. Oh, there's some apples. I'm gonna eat these. Saplings. A few of them up. I'll worry about planting those later, as long as the Enderman don't steal my dirt. Would the creeper explode under here, maybe? I don't see any missing blocks. The tower looks okay, right? I hope he didn't explode there. If he exploded in the water, then maybe everything will be okay. I don't see any holes in the wall. I don't see any missing wood. I might have to climb up there and make sure everything's okay. But for now, it's still working okay, so I'm not too worried about it. Have any bits of a spawner come out of here? No, I don't see any wood or cobble that have fallen out of here. So assuming they weren't destroyed or pushed somewhere where they couldn't flow out. These guys are too far away for it to have been them. I don't know. A skeleton must have shot a creeper or something and... Ow. And, done that. Okay, let's get this door going then. I'm not going to worry about that too much. I'm probably not going to actually go up there. Whoops, what am I doing? I'll throw a door in here. And, then we have a way of collecting our things. And I'll make this a more refined thing later on. And there's a door. There's our stuff already, and eventually once we get some iron, we'll have to place a hopper down there. We'll have to make these guys so they survive, because I think the only way to actually, get iron from them is to deliver the killing blow yourself, by the sounds of it. So we'll just make a platform that's two or three blocks taller, that'll let them survive, but make them a one-hit kill, maybe even one block taller. I'll have to find that happy medium number. And we'll figure these things out later. But in the meantime, we'll just collect some of our... Ow! Zombie hit me on the way down. Collect some of these goodies. And this is a dangerous place. We already got half a stack of gunpowder, half a stack of bones, half a stack of rotten flesh, which we can feed ourselves permanently on. But this thing's working good. I am happy. I'm just going to give you guys the flyby now, as I usually do. And then that'll be it for today. So hopefully you all enjoyed. And I will see you all next time, where we'll work on something else. Something else. Bye.
We'll be right back.